The universe is a tantalizing realm of billowing galaxies, terrorizing black holes, mysterious planets, and then we get to asteroids. These lone gray worlds seem to have all the hype right now, and if we have so much going on in the universe, why are we so focused on sending spacecraft to these drifting rocks? I mean, they're not exactly easy to explore. Japan's Aerospace Exploration Agency learned that the literal hard way when their spacecraft Hayabusa 2 had to launch a bullet into the rocky surface of asteroid Ryugu. Of course, it was for data collecting purposes, but it was never supposed to be that way. JAXA scientists anticipated the asteroid to have regolith, or a powdery surface of pulverized material of ice and dust. This would be easy for Hayabusa 2 to collect a sample of and add to the regolith material that was brought back from asteroid Itokawa on the first Hayabusa mission. But upon arrival, they were met with the opposite. A gravel, hard terrain. With some quick thinking, scientists made adjustments to their collection tactics before our buddy H2 made its landing. And in doing so, here on Earth, they entirely replicated the surface of an asteroid and shot it with a copy of their sampling instrument. All their testing proved successful when on February 22, 2019, the spacecraft blasted the surface of Ryugu, collecting a piece of the asteroid, which is now on its way back to us. We expect H2's valiant return in 2020. But that's not the only sample we're expecting to arrive to Earth in the coming years. NASA's OSIRIS-REx spacecraft is on a mission as well to investigate another asteroid named Bennu. Scientists recently discovered by chance that this is a rare class of asteroid, which ejects its own mass into space, leaving a trail of tinier rocks in its wake. But Hayabusa 2 and OSIRIS-REx didn't travel so far to see if asteroids are bulletproof and watch them throw up. I mean, they did. But more importantly, NASA says that asteroids are time capsules of our solar system, and these investigative missions are a way to unravel a few mysteries we still have about how it all formed and how we got here. Like, one of the biggest is that asteroids may have delivered the elements of life to Earth. Scientists believe that asteroids like Bennu, which are carbon-rich, collided with our planet during its formative years. And while the rocks didn't have oceans on them, they could have had water molecules lurking within its mineral structure and helped begin the vast life we now know and love. There's also the idea that while Earth might have been given life from an asteroid, they might have also supplied the foundations for the planets themselves. In the early beginnings of our solar system, there were just tiny particles of dust made of rock, metal, and ice swirling around our young sun. But as time passed, some bits fell into the sun and others stuck together, creating asteroids, but maybe also getting bigger into planetary bodies. We have evidence that previous asteroids Vesta and Ceres that we visited with NASA's Dawn spacecraft were internally layered with materials, with the core being the densest part, indicating that both asteroids were growing to be planets, but they never gathered enough material to do so. So an asteroid could be a leftover relic from that early evolution period of our solar system that we're still trying to figure out. But now that I've explained why asteroids are awesome, there's always a little disclaimer, and this one is that asteroids can be hazardous to Earth. There's actually an organization called the Planetary Defense Coordination Office, and they use a collection of instruments in the Near Earth Object Observations Program to keep tabs on any and all asteroids that fly by or enter our atmosphere. NASA is even working on a redirect mission called DART, where Bruce Willis takes a team of oil riggers. Just kidding, there's no Bruce. But this is a real mission, and emerging research like this simulation from Johns Hopkins University shows that it's much more difficult to destroy an asteroid than we previously thought. So this all may be new to you, but we've actually been hunting asteroids for a while now. Back in the early 2000s, NASA's Near Shoemaker was the first spacecraft to orbit and land on an asteroid. Now missions like this are standard when going to small bodies, with OSIRIS-REx, Hayabusa 1 and 2, Rosetta Philae, and New Horizons. And they've taught us so much already. Hayabusa 2, although not yet back with its sample, has already detected that the Ryugu asteroid is drier than anticipated, and actually that it's quite young, only around 100 million years old. This suggests that wherever it stemmed from was probably devoid of water too, which might change our current understanding of what the solar system looked like 100 million years ago. And OSIRIS-REx, remember, lucked out with Bennu being an active asteroid. Out of the 8,000 asteroids discovered, there have been just 12 observed releasing the material into space. so all observations from Bennu are valuable, and it has plenty of time to prepare for its sample mission in July 2020. But what's in store for the future? Let me introduce Mission Psyche. NASA wants to send a spacecraft for the first time to a nearly entirely metal asteroid named Psyche. Psyche is special because it might be a piece of metallic core that's similar to Earth, that we can actually study. Earth's core is way too hot to investigate, and now it's our opportunity to do so and understand how Earth and other rocky planets formed. Plus, the center of our magnetic field is our metallic core, so this might help us understand that too, hopefully. NASA's estimated arrival to Psyche will be in 2026. So floating space rocks such as asteroids are unique to our understanding of our solar system. They may hold the key answers to our burning questions, and all we have to do is capture them, one spacecraft at a time. Still want to know more about the missions ahead? Comment down below on the specifics that you're looking for, and check out this video about Oumuamua, the mysterious interstellar asteroid that flew right by us. Subscribe for more science in your day, and thanks for watching Seeker.